What's up? Oh, no, I'm good. I'm trying to get some projects done. I got tons of stuff to do to work on, and Jack's good. Yes. Tomorrow, maybe? No, I don't want to do it tomorrow. No. Having to leave tomorrow, having to get packed and everything. Let's do it another time. I appreciate it. You guys go. I'll catch up with it. I really appreciate it, though.
Okay.
I love you.
Love you.
All right, talk to you later. Bye. Man, busy weekend. All right, got tons of stuff going on. What I want to show you how to do is paint 3D printed parts. There are a lot of tutorials out there to do this. I've seen some other dudes do this stuff before, but there's a lot of weirdness. It's actually really simple because it's just like painting plastic. The only difference is that 3D printed parts are put down in layers. They have these lines that go through the parts. And a lot of folks like to smooth out those lines before they paint it or they do something with it next. So let me show you how I get through this process, but I do it quickly. And I get a pretty good result. Is it perfect? Of course not. If you want something perfect, you just need to sand it down, treat it like normal plastic, make sure it's perfectly smooth, then paint it. But if you want something that's pretty good, I'll show you a quick shortcut. Let's get started. This is a cell phone mount for your car that I've been working on, and it's really cool. And I want to paint it to get an idea of what some different colors would look like in this. But as you can see, 3D printed parts tend to get laid down in layers. So they have these ridges and they have little, you know, parts that aren't uniform and things like that. Well, some people will tell you, well, you can just solve this problem by the settings on your printer. Not necessarily the case. It depends on what types of materials you're using, how fast you want to print it, and that type of thing. So this is what I'm talking about. You see how it's real unsmooth right here? It almost looks like wood grain because it came down in layers, because this is a three-dimensional rounded part, and it still has to do it basically two dimensions at a time. So let me show you how to go from this step to the next step and get this ready to paint. Really, the first step is you want to get rid of at least the big rough parts. Two things to use at this stage: some really coarse sandpaper. This is actually 60 grit, which is pretty ruthless. And I also use a wire brush for the more intricate parts. So I'm going to use some regular primer, but it's also designed to stick to plastic. So I'm going to skip the adhesion promoter step. But if I was worried about durability, I would still do adhesion promoter, then primer. So I'm going straight to primer that basically has a little bit of plastic adhesion promoter in it. So let's get started. So as you can see, after only one coat of primer — primer dries really quick too, it's pretty awesome — but you can see straight through the primer and still see I have plenty of lines. So I'm gonna do several coats of primer. You can do a lot of coats of primer and it's usually not an issue, but make sure between your coats it's getting nice and dry, because if you have one layer of primer in there that's wet and then a bunch of dry layers on top, it'll take a long time to cure and can do some really weird stuff. So just a lot of layers. The more layers, the more smooth your project will be. I'm going to do about four or five, but I'm going to make sure that between layers that it is definitely dry. As you get more familiar with doing stuff like this, you'll know how long to spend during this step. It depends on how flat or how smooth you really, really want your project. You can sand, prime as many times as you want, honestly, until you get it crazy smooth if you really, really want. But I'm just trying to get to pretty good because I don't want to spend all day working on this. I just want to get it painted. So I put about two or three coats of primer on here. Now I'm ready to cut that primer down. Remember though, I want to cut the high spots down, but leave the primer inside of the grooves, which will give me a more overall smooth appearance. So don't necessarily go with the grain as you sand your project. You can go against the grain at this stage. Two things I like to use at this stage: Scotch-Brite pad. You can either use the green ones or the red ones. The red ones are usually automotive, which means they're just red. I don't know, they might be a little bit different coarseness. I've never been able to tell the difference. And then some sandpaper. At this stage, I like to get into the higher grits, maybe somewhere around 400, 600, 800. Really, I've got 600 right here, but this is much more coarse, so I'm gonna first hit it with my Scotch-Brite pad, then clean it up just a little bit with my 600, and then we're ready for paint. Smoother surface of a project. The primer looks pretty good right now. We're ready for paint. Now remember, smooth strokes, light coats. Light coats, smooth strokes. The reason is because if you gob on too much primer, not a big deal, you can sand it down. But once you start painting, you want to have a very even surface. So make sure you're using very, very light coats. And it shouldn't take, especially with a dark primer, like a dark color, and then I'm using black on top of that, so dark on top of dark, I shouldn't have to use that many coats of paint. I'm really probably gonna dust on two really light coats as long as I get a really nice smooth coverage. But I'm going to make sure to take my time so it doesn't drip or gob up or look bad. So, time for paint.
Take a second to show you something that really pisses me off, but it happens all the time. Just bought a new can of paint, ready to go use it. There's no cap. It is super frustrating. But don't freak out, it's not a big deal. All you have to do is go in your garage, find the same brand, and just use a cap from another one of them. But I did want to take a second just to tell you how much it frustrates me, just like anybody else. Really frustrating. Whoever's out there stealing caps, I'm gonna find you one of these days. I'm gonna find you. I've got two or three really good layers of paint on my project now. Now I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna smooth the paint out just a tiny bit. If you cut through paint too much, with whether you're using a scratchy pad or 600 grit sandpaper, you just gotta be careful, because if you cut all the way through the paint, now you're down into the primer and you'll notice it in your final product. But if you take your time and just scuff down the paint just a little bit and smooth it out, you'll not notice any difference once you put the clear coat on top of it. And once you put the clear coat on top of it, you get a much smoother surface if you cut it down between layers of paint. So I'm done with paint. Now I'm gonna scuff it down just a tiny bit to smooth it out, but not go all the way through the paint, and then I'm gonna clear coat. So this is what the final product looks like. Is it perfect? Absolutely not. But for 2 hours of time, I would say two and a half hours of time, it looks pretty good. And it's certainly a lot smoother than the original 3D print. So I want to show you how this new cell phone mount actually works. This is my cell phone. It's a Nexus 6. So it's a 6-inch. And really, in reality, it's a little bit bigger than that, especially with a case, but it's not a thick case. But it is, you know, basically your normal big new phone right now. Just like the new iPhones, the new big ones, the Plus or whatever, 7 Plus. It's about the same size. So it's just the big screen cell phone. And the concept here is that with the little feet on the bottom of my model, they tilt and they move around, the little ball joints. So it can sit on your dashboard using these little 3M stickies. I don't have one on my desk. I'll show you one in a second. But little 3M stickies, but it'll fit on any uneven surface on your dashboard. So all you do is you take your cell phone and you put it in here and reach back, grab the two retention straps,
And being shock cored, they just go over the corners really easily and they sit right there. I was really excited about this because I wanted a cool mount for my cell phone, for my car. And I was thinking in terms of like off-road as well. And once it's in here, man, it's really, really secure. So this model will be available on my Thingiverse page very soon. I don't know exactly when. I'm still working on it. I'm still tweaking some things. I really like it. I don't like the fact that it takes two hands to actually put your cell phone in, but once it's in, it's amazing. It's so secure and it's so much tighter than all the commercial versions of cell phone mounts out right there. And I think that it looks much cooler, so that's kind of why I went down this road. But as you can see, and this is what you see, remember, through the dashboard of your car when you have your cell phone mounted, so I wanted it to make sure it looked cool too. Do is, you know, pull the straps off and it comes right out. So you can definitely do that with one hand. I'm still working on the design aspect of being able to do it, put it in there with one hand. But so when you reach across your dash, I'll show you once I get this model a little bit more refined. When you do this with two hands, it can be kind of a pain, especially if you have to reach across your car to do it. But I'm still working on it. I think it's really cool. I really like how it looks. And I started this project thinking about like an off-road look and what a cell phone mount for like a really cool off-road car would look like, or off-road truck. So that was what I was kind of going for, and I think it looks awesome right now. But I still have a little bit of work to do. So, long story short, the concept here is the fact that you don't need to do anything crazy to paint 3D printed projects, but it does help, and you can cheat a little bit by using primer, because primer actually fills in a little bit between those layers of your 3D print and can give you a much smoother final result. But you don't need to go out and buy anything special or different because it's 3D printed. It's just like painting plastic. You still need to use adhesion promoter, but you can also use primer to fill in a little bit. And this is a trick that automotive painters have been using for years. So I hope you learned something. I'm just trying to show you some tricks and try to cut down the time that it takes to put together a pretty cool project. So if you got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandedDesigns.com. I'm Tony D. Bit of an update. I found the cap. The cap simply came off when I took the cap off. So it popped off. It was on the ground. I noticed it when I was walking back in my house. So I apologize to anybody I offended from accusing you of stealing the caps off of spray paint. But we all know it happens. We all know you go get a can of spray paint, you open it up and it doesn't have a cap. But whatever. I found it. So let's move on.